Hello and what is going on, stick guys? Tomcat here and welcome to MX vs. ATV All Out. Now, I was a big fan of MX vs. ATV Unleashed back in the day on PS2. I was a little bit of a fan of Reflex, not a massive fan, but a little bit of a fan. And I decided to jump back in and give All Out a try. I know it's been out for a little while now, but I haven't played it yet. And all I've really done in this game is the tutorial. So I haven't really played any further into the game than that, and I figured why not share it with you guys, because it is a very fun game. Although I've only really played it for about 30 minutes. So without any further ado, this is going to kick off our new Let's Play series of MX vs. ATV All Out, and I hope you guys enjoy and stay tuned. Now, the first thing we need to do is we need to see where we want to go as far as like setting up our rider and stuff like that, because I've literally done nothing. So, let's see. Rider number is going to be, 97? Because why would it not be 97? Let's see. Rider name is going to be TC. And let's see. Goggles, gear, gloves, boots. We'll sort all that out later. Yeah, we'll sort all that stuff out later. So, not really too concerned about it. Let's see. What is this? Brap. Build rider and AI profiles. Got it. Dealership where we could go to purchase stuff. Tuning where we could modify our bike or our ATV or what have you. And I think, honestly, before we do any of that, we're going to go ahead and have some fun and see what we can do. Now, I'm going to warm up a little bit before we actually start, getting crazy with anything. But let's see. Well, that's a good way to get started. Whoop. Here we go. A little bit of a trick. Ooh. Oh, I don't know if we have enough time to double that. Oh. Oh, I thought we had just barely enough. The cool thing about this game is that you can actually pop the clutch. If you want, like, to give yourself a little bit more, to give yourself a little bit of a boost, you can pop the clutch. And I was a little bit iffy, like, on how it was going to feel at first, but it's actually not a bad idea. Like, it's not a bad system. It actually really does work. So, you can power slide, you can do whatever you want to, and I like how everything feels super fluid. Like, most games generally end up not feeling fluid. And it really takes away a lot from the experience, especially games where you're on some kind of bike. You know what I mean? And anything where you're on a bike, because when you're on a real bike, and I'm by no means like some sort of like, you know, super proficient rider, you know, like I can get around on a bike, but, you know, like I said, I'm not some sort of like, you know, insane rider or anything like that. But the whole thing behind anything on a, like any game that involves riding a bike really needs to have that. Oh god, my rhythm is bad at the moment. I need to warm up. But yeah, that's gonna happen just more and more as I play the game. But yeah, you need to have that feel. You really need to have that feel, and that's probably the most important thing to capture in a game like this. So let's see. Series, amateur off-road, amateur motocross, indoor open cross. Let's start with amateur motocross. Well, no, you know what? Let's start with amateur off-road. Yeah, medium, no practice, no qualify, 3 laps. Let's go. Oh, wow, that's a good number of events. That's more events than I thought it was going to have, that's for sure. I've also turned off the music because I do not want to have to deal with YouTube copyright on the music. It's like, some people say, you know, don't worry about it, it's in the game itself. And I'm like, eh, there's really no point in, like, screwing with it, though. There's, like, a couple of quad bikes. Wow, that was perfect. That was perfect. So this is literally, like a go-wherever-you-want type idea. So, well, go wherever you want to get to the waypoints however you see fit. Ah! Okay, yeah, that wasn't gonna work. Yo, what up, guys? Oh, no, we didn't even get the checkpoint. I thought we did, but we didn't. Excuse me. So, ooh, yeah, the best idea, I think, is going to be to stay down in this, like, creek bed. Not even... Really, bro? Dude, he came and, like, basically like, what would you even call it? Like, sideswiped me. All right, let's see if we can stick with these guys. I just need to go ahead and get as far ahead as I possibly can. Ooh, I'm not going to make that. Yeah, that was sketchy. I'm not going to make that. So we're about halfway up in the pack right now. If we can get a little bit further ahead, scrub that jump. Scrub as many of these as you can. Oh, God. Hi. Oh, okay. That was almost good timing. Wasn't exactly perfect timing, but it was almost good timing. Just stick with it. It's going to be all about finding a decent route, because these guys that are up in front are pretty quick. These guys in the top three, definitely fairly quick. He just had an issue, though. Oh, geez. Oh, God. What? How? I thought I set that up properly. What the heck? Oh, geez. Damn. That's just a sketchy... What? Oh, God. We have one more gate. Wait. Forfeit or quit event. You can't restart? What? I had no idea you couldn't restart. Okay, that gives a lot more pressure to these events now. You definitely have to be a lot more on your toes then. Let's see. Single event from the series. Well, but that's... I guess we'll go to... I need to practice the amateur off-road. Let's go to amateur motocross. And we'll do... Yeah, next event, Maple Hill. Alright, this is gonna be much simpler to get into because it's an actual track. I didn't really anticipate that being an issue. So, to be honest, I'm gonna need a little bit more practice, I think, before I'm properly competitive in those. There we go. Gotta, like, get that clutch dump at the right time, and then you're a lot better off. Easy. Oh, God. Easy. That was actually really good. It was managed well. My line in that corner was crap. Absolutely terrible. Stick with it, though. Be easy. Be easy. That wasn't brilliant, but it was okay. I need to get better also at managing speed in, like, a slide. Because if you can manage your speed in a slide in this game, you've got, like, then you've figured it out. You've figured the system out. And because you could be so fast if you can manage your speed in a slide that it's really incredible how fast you can be. I'm actually surprised at how many of these jumps that you don't need to preload for. A lot of them you really don't. And I still love the terrain deformation. Like, I love how the ground actually does get legitimately cut out by the tires of the bikes. And the laps change and the lines change the more you play. I think that's a huge, huge deal with this game. And it definitely shows that there's a lot more... It shows that there's actual depth to the terrain deformation system, and it works very well. Works very, very well. Whoop! Easy! Easy, and up! Oh my God, that's huge. I'm gonna scrub that one. Yeah, that one was much better off scrubbed, and that's one of those things that, like, you kind of figure out as you go what jumps to scrub and what jumps to actually preload for. This one I'm gonna... Yeah, I didn't even preload at all, and it was good to go. It was easy. Especially once everybody else cuts out a line, it basically gives you this second bit of track that you can use. This second bit of banked track that you can use. But yeah, if you slide out of it into a different line, you definitely realize that there's... Oh, God. You definitely realize that there's a lot more... You slide out a lot more if you're either off from the actual, you know, banked line of the track or out of everybody else's ruts. And then there's some sections of the track that are just so torn up that you can kind of go wherever you want and you'll still find some rut to put the bike in. Ooh, that was sketchy. That was bad. That was, like, the way that I attacked it was just bad. Not bad. Pretty simple, to be honest. Like, I think the biggest thing is going forward from here. I think the biggest thing is going to be, you know, keeping that pace up. And as long as I can keep that pace up. All right, so Crimson Creek is next. And I think these will probably all be slightly different. But it's weird how these are so, in my mind anyway, so much easier than the cross, like, I call them cross-country events because that's what they feel like, but. Man, if you can get that launch timed perfectly, you can be out of the hole no problem. Like, and you can destroy everybody off the line. Oh, God. He's trying to clear the water. This is definitely a bit of a different track. Ooh, boy. There we go. Went a little wide, but not too bad. Oh, jeez. Stay back. Uh-oh. Ow. Yeah, that was just bad. That was one of those mistakes where, like, I saw it coming, and, like, while we were in the air, I was like, oh, God. I was like, there is no way that that's going to end up good. God, we're getting passed by everybody. Ooh, what is this? Come on. I do not want to do... Oh, God. What the... Holy crap. 16th out of 16. Second lap already. Okay, so we have a lot of work to do, apparently. We have a lot of work to do to catch these guys. And... honestly, I think it was like, dude, it was one of those things where, like, if you mess up a little bit, then you're definitely in a position to where, like, if you screw up a little bit, it's gonna take a good bit to fix. Easy. I don't know how much coming back from that there is. But, oh, I would very much like there to be a form of coming back. I just, oh, this is sketchy now. This is really sketchy now because it's the second out of three laps, and we're all the way in the back. We're literally all the way in the back of the pack, and I'm iffy on whether or not we're going to be able to catch up properly at this point. And I don't, oh, man, I don't want you guys to have to sit through restarts. That was just enough. That was just enough. Okay, you know what? If you could... Oh, my God. Oh, my God. There's no way. I mean, I don't know how we went from doing so well to really actually basically sucking now. I think I'm also... Ooh, I'm also probably getting just a little bit too... No! Oh, my God. All right, I think to finish this off, we're probably going to try another track, like Dove Point, and see if we can do a little bit better there, because I'd really like to finish with a victory. I'm kind of like, it's kind of one of those things where, like, if you get out in front and you, like, once you get out in front, you have got to stay there. If you get out in front and you can't stay there, you're basically screwed. Oh, crap. Okay. I forgot that these didn't have a light. Oh, God. Oh, God, that's wide. Oh, geez, that's too wide. Oh, somebody wiped out. Somebody hella wiped out. Okay. Easy. Why is that considered off track? We were plenty on the track. I don't understand that. Like, that was weird. Ease it up. Oh, there we go. That was nice and smooth. We just lost a crap ton of speed. Like, an actual crap ton of speed. Ooh. Oh, should have preloaded there. Okay, see, I still need to learn this track. Oh, I thought the track went straight. That's really dangerous when you think the track goes straight and it doesn't, that has a lot of potential to screw up your race. Bro! I noticed something, and I keep noticing it about the AI in this game. They have absolutely either no awareness of you or no problem hitting you. They seem like they're very much a an AI system that's like, I know where I'm going, and screw you if that's where you are, because that's where I'm going. So easy. That was kind of you know what? That actually worked out better than I expected it to. Okay. Easy. It's all about the consistency. It is 100% about the consistency in this game. Oh, God. There it is. Saved that. It was kind of sketchy on like, I didn't know if I was going to make the jump or not. But still ended up saving it, so it works out. Oh, God. Come on. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. There we go. Not too bad, not too bad. All right, lap two out of three now. Trying not to wash wide, but I am also trying to carry a lot of speed. Carrying a lot of speed is the... Whoa! Okay, I don't know what that was, but the bike really started to pitch backwards a lot. Easy. Oh, God, easy. No need to preload on that. Use the brakes a little bit. Pop the clutch a little bit. It didn't really do much. I don't want to know. Okay, so I'm like about 3 seconds ahead. About. So that's a pretty good lead if I can keep it consistent. And it also seems like this on this track, there's more jumps that you would want to preload rather than jumps that you wouldn't want to preload, because like the last track that we were doing, I can't remember the name of it, but the last track that we did, there was a lot of jumps that you didn't want to preload, like where actually preloading would hurt you. It would hurt your time and it would hurt your position in the race. This track, there's a lot of jumps where you do want to preload, like this one. Like if you can make it all the way up and over that, you give yourself a really big advantage. That one is like you take the first jump kind of almost wrong in the interest of taking the second jump smoothly. Whether or not that works remains to be like, well, I mean, hey, we're still out in front, so I guess it works to some degree. First one I preloaded a little bit. Oh, no, 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 no. That's where popping the clutch really helps. I mean, we're 5 seconds ahead. I don't know how we managed to stay that far ahead. I mean, I was assuming that one of the guys would catch us up immediately, but... Easy. Problem is, when the bike gets into, like, that bouncing motion, if the bike gets into a bouncing motion, you better be ready. See, that was terrible. Should not have preloaded on that one. That one I didn't even need to. I don't know why I did. It's more of like a force of habit thing, because like you get used to doing it and then you're like, oh yeah, I should do it here. I should do it here and I should do it here. And like a little bit of a miniature whip type thing. I don't know. It looks like it's helping me a little bit. That apparently seems to be the line everybody's taking. I need to stop preloading for that. I also need to figure out how to carry more speed through it though. Really glad I didn't preload for that one. Because if I had, then I would have gone straight. And straight is not the direction you want to go there. Not the direction you want to go whatsoever. Oh, God. Split. Oh, wow. Eights? Well, I was up in the eights. That was like 8 seconds. That's crazy. It's still right about at 8 seconds. Clutch kick saved that jump. It genuinely saved that jump. Throwing a little bit of a trick in there just because, I mean, I know I'm still kind of getting used to this game. I know I'm still definitely a noob at it, but I could throw in a little bit of style here and there. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Oh, go, 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 go. All right, I know when I see the Troy Lee Designs banner, I know I'm getting close to the finish. That was just about, I didn't need that much height on the second jump, but that was about the rhythm, the exact rhythm that I wanted. Come on, and there's the finish. Finish with a backflip. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Totally up for finishing with a backflip. That worked. It worked well. I guess it's that just that one track that's, like, really, really hard to get the actual rhythm down on. But, like, to be honest, guys, like, it's really fun. Like, in general, it's super, super fun. Now, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 more tracks in this series to finish. And let's see. We'll exit that. We'll exit that, and we'll go back to the compound for a minute, because I do want to show you guys what you can do when you just mess around with the you mess around with like the freestyle area. It's insane. Oh, can we land it though? No, not that one. I was like, can we land it though? No. What is this? What the hell is that? Go, 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 go. Ooh, that was awesome. That was big, too. Oh, nope, not gonna make that. Oh. You have to hold the left trigger down to do that, and I forgot. Oh, and that put me in a slightly terrifying position. There we go. There's the double front flip. I'm gonna go in here, pick up some speed before I go back the other way. No, 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 no! There it is. Ow. I'm trying to mix something with a backflip, just because I feel like it would be... You know what looks really crazy is when you mix something with a 360. When you mix something with a 360, that just looks insane. Holy crap, if we were able to, like, dude, if we were able to land that, that would have been absolutely bonkers. That would have been absolutely just bonkers. What the? Oh, that was weird. That was super weird. Like, I don't know what we did. Oh, God. Yep, that's not gone well. But I do love that the menu for this game is, I mean, and of course it has a menu of its own, but it's just this, like, open compound, you know what I mean? Like, and you can just mess around in here and practice, and I think that that's out. That's so valuable. That's so valuable because you can just, like, come out here and just practice and learn, you know? And that's, like, one of the most valuable things about the way they set this thing up because... What the? I keep resetting myself. I'm not doubling that. There's no way I'm doubling that. But yeah, I love the way that they've set this up because they've given you this basically playground. And then if you want to just pause it and figure out where you want to go from there, you can. But if you guys enjoyed this very first episode of MX vs. ATV All Out, don't forget to click that like button. Tell me in the comments below what you guys thought of it. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe for more. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Talk to y'all later.